Dear students, today we will be having a study of pouch packing machine. So here we are seeing a pouch packing machine, single head. So this particular pouch packing machine is used to pack milk and milk product pouches, specifically in liquid state. So here we can see this is the film which is coming from the back side of the machine. We will be visiting in a moment. So at this part, this film will be formed into a tube. So this is known as collar of this machine. So here we can see that this is the collar of the machine where this film will be mounted and wrapped around this collar, so that when the film will be pulled in the downward direction, it will form into this tube form. So here we are seeing that film has been formed in the tube shape, and these are the rollers which are directing this tube to go through this sealing jaw. So this is the vertical sealing jaw. This vertical sealing jaw has an electrical element which is used to heat seal the pouch in the vertical direction. So here we can see that this pouch film is overlapping here, and this overlapping part will be passing behind this vertical sealing jaw, wherein this overlap part will get sealed together and form this kind of seal. So that we are getting a final tube shape. Then this pouch or this film in the tube form will be coming down under to this particular location. Here we can see that this is the pulling mechanism. So what this will do is, it is operated by cam and camshaft mechanism. So it will be holding this pouch film and drying it in the downward direction. So at this side we can see, so here we are having a slot in the machine. So this slot in the machine, what it will do is, it will be used to direct this film in the downward direction. So when this jaw will be opening, it will come to the top side, it will grab the film, and then it will drag the film in the downward direction and release the film when it reaches the downside of this slot. After that, this film will be going through this horizontal sealing jaw. So here we are seeing that we are having a pair of sealing jaw, one at the back end, another at the front end. So here also we are having electrical connection. So in this electrical connection, we can see that this electrical connection will be used to heat this jaw, and these jaw will be, when they are coming together near to each other, they will be sealing the pouch to form a horizontal seal. When the pouch will be horizontally sealed, then through this product tube inside this machine, here we can see this, up till here we are having a product transfer line. So from this product transfer line, the milk or milk product in the liquid state will get filled into the pouch which will be filling. So here we can see this is a pipeline which is coming from the top till this point. So when the pouch will be sealed in the horizontal direction, then the milk, lassi or similar kind of product will get filled into this pouch, and then again the pull push mechanism of the machine will be pulling one pouch length of the film and sealing the horizontal jaw again. So what we will be having is intermittent sealing for both horizontal and vertical jaw. So vertical jaw and horizontal jaw, when they will be sealing, at that time filling operations will be occurring, as well as the film will not move. When the film will be moving, both these jaws will be disengaged and film will be only moved, and no filling operation will be occurring at that time. So here we can see this is the product transfer line coming from the top of the machine, which is reaching up till the horizontal sealing jaw condition. And here we can see the control panel of the machine. So in this control panel of machine, we can see this is vertical sealing temperature controller, this is horizontal sealing temperature controller, and then we are having other controls such as sterilizing lamp, temperature control, powering on and off of the machine, then starting and stopping the machine, and pouch counter. So this pouch counter will be counting how many number of pouches have been packed by this machine. Starting and stopping operation will be controlled by turning this knob to one of the sides, either towards the start side or towards the stop side. Sterilizing lamp, which is located at the back side. So this sterilizing lamp will be operated by this switch. Temperature control for both these controllers will be switched on by this switch. Main power to the machine will be powered on or switched on by using this particular switch. So here we can see, this is the filling mechanism. So we are having a piston and cylinder mechanism which will be sucking the milk product from this transfer line. So this is the product transfer line which will be connected to the milk tank or milk can from which the milk product is required to be filled into the pouch. It will be sucked into the cylinder and then discharged from the cylinder by this pipeline. So this is the pipeline which is coming up to the top and then entering the machine from this end. So this will be entering from this particular end. Now coming on to the back side of this machine. So at the back side of the machine, we can see various mechanisms of the machine, how they will be working. So starting at the bottommost side, so here we can see this is the piston rod. So this is the piston rod which will be moved by this particular gearbox arrangement here. So this whole machine is operated by one single electrical motor. Here we can see this is the electrical motor, main prime mover of the machine, which is been mounted by this pulley and loaded by this V-band. So this is the power transmission system. The power from the motor will be transmitted to this gearbox by using this V-band drive, and this gearbox is having a shaft. So here we can see this shaft is extending up till this point here at the top, and at the bottom side through the gearbox also it is protruding at the bottom side. So at the bottom side we can see this scale. So this scale is for adjustment of the stroke length. So at the piston we are having control of stroke length depending on what amount of material is required to be filled in the machine, whether it is 200 ml, 500 ml or 1 liter. Depending on the pouch film selected, we can adjust the stroke length by loosening or tightening this nut and then moving this piston rod front and back. So if we move the piston rod a little bit back side, then there will be larger stroke length and more volume will be sucked into the piston. If we move it towards the front side, means this particular side, then there will be less stroke length and less of the material will be filled into the piston. So here we are seeing that this is the main piston rod, and this piston rod will be moving to and fro, means backward and forward, so that here in this particular cylinder we will be having filling and emptying operation. So here we are seeing this particular pipeline is connecting to this piston head, and this piston head is also connected by this pipeline only to this discharge line. So at these two ends we are having NRVs. This NRV will be only supporting the flow from bottom side to the top side, and this will be also supporting the flow from the bottom side to the top side. That means when this piston will be sucking the material, it cannot suck from this line, but it will be sucking from this particular line only, because the reverse flow direction, means from top to bottom flow direction, will be prevented by this NRV, and the flow will be happening from this suction line. When this piston will be in discharge stroke, then this NRV will be stopping the flow in the bottom direction and all of the flow will go in this top direction only, so that we can have a control of volumetric flow rate by using these two NRVs and piston and cylinder mechanism. Now coming on to the other mechanisms attached to this gearbox. So at this gearbox we can see that this shaft which is mounted on the gearbox is connected first to this cam. So here we are seeing this cam, and in this particular cam we are seeing that it is connected to this particular mechanism here. This mechanism is pushing or pulling the connecting rod of the pusher arm. The pusher arm which I showed you in the front end has been controlled by this particular mechanism here. So we can see that in this cam, when this will be rotating, when this side will be coming at this particular part, then there will be spring back action which will be opening those grabber rods, and when this is in this particular position right now, it is in the holding position. Now when we move a little bit upwards, then we can see then there is a pair of bevel gears. So these bevel gears are doing two simultaneous things at one go. One is conversion of horizontal rotation direction into vertical rotation direction or vice versa. So when this shaft is rotating in this horizontal plane, then by using this bevel gear, this second bevel gear will be rotating in the vertical plane, and it will be controlling the motion of this particular rod in this side. So this particular rod will be then controlling the up and down motion of the grabber assembly. So whole grabber assembly will be controlled. Whole grabber assembly will be controlled by using this particular shaft here, and it will be holding and grabbing all together. When we come a little bit on the top side, we can see one more cam is there. So this particular cam is for operating the vertical sealing jaw. So vertical sealing jaw is mounted on this particular cam by using this bearing here, which is spring mounted. We can see there is a spring which is pushing back the vertical jaw. So when this cam will be rotating, it will be sequentially pushing and pulling that vertical sealing jaw against the pouch. We can also see that there is one pin here. So there is one pin attached to this cam, which will be while rotating touching this counter. So there is a counter at this side. When there will be one full rotation, it will be pressing this counter. So in this particular counter, we are having a ticker counter. So this ticker counter is directly connected to the counter which I showed you in the front of the machine. Now moving further towards the top side, here we can see this is the location where the pouch film roll will be mounted. So in this pouch film roll mounting position, we can see that we are having a coating mechanism also placed. So this coating mechanism, it will be printing the batch number, rice and other related information onto the pouch while the pouch film is rolling or rotating. So as and when the pouch will be rotated by that pusher mechanism, the pouch will be rotating simultaneously. This mechanism will also print onto that date and pricing or information, batch number information onto the pouch, and finally the pouch will get printed at this particular end before filling only. After that, we can film is going via this roller. So this roller is for guiding. So this is called as a guide roll. So this guide roll will be guiding the film to go to the front end of the machine. Now at this end, so this end we are having a provision to connect a UV lamp. So UV lamp has been uninstalled for maintenance purpose right now. So we have a provision to install UV lamp so that the pouch film can be sterilized by using ultraviolet light before the filling of pouch commences. So here we can see, so for powering up the machine, we have a contactor and this is the MCB. So power will be going through this MCB via contactor to the main control panel of the machine. So this was in short the working and construction of the pouch packing machine.